In this lesson, we're going to run our server setup script on our new EC2 instance to set it up and install all the required applications and our REST API app. So let's get started. Make sure that you're logged into the EC2 instance like I explained in the previous lesson. So head over to your AWS console, copy the address, the DNS address of our server, and type SSH Ubuntu at, and then paste in the address. Oops, didn't copy properly. SSH Ubuntu at, hit enter. Okay, so once we're connected to the server and we're logged in as the Ubuntu user, we're going to make sure we have a tool called wget installed on the server. This is a tool that we can use to download files from a HTTP server on our Linux server using the command line. So type sudo apt-get install wget and hit enter. You can see that it already came installed with Ubuntu, so we don't need to install it. All right, so next we need to identify the file on GitHub that we want to download to our server. So we want to head over to our GitHub page, and when you load it up, you'll see this homepage here, or this main project page. I'm going to click on the deploy folder, and then we want to choose this server setup.sh script. Okay, so once you've found this file, we want to get the URL to download the raw file. So click on the raw button here, and you can see it just outputs the plain text file. Copy the URL of that file, and then head back to our SSH, and then type wget, and then paste the URL and hit enter. If you type ls, it will show you that it has downloaded the file to our home directory on the server. So now you can type, or we want to make this file executable so we can run this file on our server. The way that you do that is you use the chmod command. So chmod plus x and then the name of the file. What this does is it uses the chmod command to add the executable permission to this file. So if we were to put a minus instead of a plus here, it would take away the executable permissions. But we want to add it, so we use a plus x and then hit enter. If we type ls again, you can see that it's turned green. It may not turn green if you're using a different operating system such as Linux or Mac. It may be a different color, but the point is that it changes because it's become executable. Finally, let's run this script to set up our REST API on the server. So type sudo and then the name of the script. Sorry, sudo dot forward slash and then the name of the script, server underscore setup dot ssh, or sorry, dot sh. Hit enter, and this is going to run the script that we created in one of the previous lessons. It's going to run it on our server, and this should install all the dependencies and all the applications we require to get our REST API working. So let's go ahead and wait for that to finish. It should take a few minutes to install all the dependencies, and then we can continue to the next lesson. Okay, you can see that the script is done because it output this done smiley face at the bottom. So our server should now be set up to run our API. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.